So we study athletes after ACL injury and reconstruction. We study how they move, how they walk, and how we can rehabilitate them better. We're studying joint kinematics and kinetics, or joint angles and the forces that go across the joints. We also use surface electromyography, or EMG. This captures muscle activity, which we then normalize to their maximal volitional contraction, or their MVC, which tells us how much that muscle can contract. What's the maximal activity of the muscle? Kick. Athletes after ACL injury, or really anyone after ACL injury and reconstruction, typically demonstrates interlimb asymmetry during gait or walking, as well as during other tests. And the hallmark sign is that limb that underwent the injury and the reconstructive surgery typically moves less. It goes through what we call less excursion, or a smaller range of motion. That's both in extension, or when your leg is straight, as well as in flexion, or when your leg is bent. In the physical therapy clinic, we study athletes also after ACL reconstruction.
Kick.
So we're really focusing on this spot right here at the 7 second mark. We look at functional tests. So we look at strength, particularly how strong their quadriceps muscles are, which is a muscle that has significant problems with activation and atrophy after ACL injury and reconstruction. We also study how they jump. This is a great way to look at interlimb symmetry in a functional manner, similar to going back to sport. We have them perform a series of hop tests. We compare those side to side, and we see if there's deficits that persist on that involved limb. In our rehabilitation portion of the study, we provide them feedback about their landing mechanics and things that they might be able to do better, so that they would reduce their risk for second injury, which is, of course, a major problem in our area of study.